加拿大今年的热浪，它一次破纪录是破到四度。
This year's heat wave in Canada broke the record with a 4 to 5 degrees Celsius rise. Statistically speaking, for such extreme temperatures to rise at such rates is considered a once in 5,000 years probability.
其实地球的二氧化碳是整个大气圈的问题。
The Earth's carbon dioxide problem is linked to the entire global atmosphere. It won't become better just because you are doing better in Taiwan. The sandstorms of Mongolia will reach Taiwan in a breeze. NASA has a picture that shows in 3 days it would reach East Asia. With winds blowing in a certain direction, it would go straight to Taiwan, and within 7 more days, it would reach the U.S., California.
Hello everyone, I'm Wade, your knowledge host. This year alone, we have experienced extreme weather conditions on every continent. From heat waves and fires throughout the Northwest America, to burned out towns in Canada, to forest fires in Serbia, and locally, dried out water reservoirs in Taiwan. Then came heavy rains flooding Taipei, Japan, China, New York City, Germany, and Spain to name a few, with landslides that followed.Extreme weather concerns are no longer a problem of the future, but the now. It was in 1967 that Shukru Manaba, winner of this year's Nobel Prize in Physics, had predicted that the surface temperature of the Earth would increase by at least 2 degrees Celsius if the concentration of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere doubled. Unfortunately, with this knowledge, that would mean that we've wasted 54 years since that warning. And if we start the count with the 2006 release of Al Gore's documentary, An Inconvenient Truth,That would mean we've had 15 years since that call to action.
那这个就是非常重要的。
This is very important because when we talk about climate change, carbon dioxide is the most important, or I should say it's the most serious greenhouse gas related to human activities. From 1958 to present day, it has increased by 2 to 3 ppm every year. So in the long run, when you see carbon dioxide related causes,One must realize that human activities certainly have an effect on climate change.
By chance, the COVID-19 pandemic stopped most human activities for over a year. This provided a much-needed recovery time with many heavy air-polluted places seeing clear blue skies and excellent air quality. So, why are we still experiencing extreme weather events despite this? Dr. Lin, a meteorology researcher of the Central University,explains that air quality is different from greenhouse gas.
二氧化碳本身其实它不算空气污染。
Carbon dioxide itself is actually not considered air pollution. Where does the largest source of carbon dioxide come from? Of course, it's burning fossil fuels. Despite the pandemic, people still need to use electricity, still need to generate electricity, and to generate thermal power.Motorbikes and cars continue to burn and emit gases, though the bulk of it still comes from power plants.
Air pollution and greenhouse gas emissions, particularly in regards to carbon dioxide emissions and air quality issues, although related, are not the same thing. Most of the typhoon passed by Taiwan's border last year, none made landfall. The cause, though related to climate change, isn't the main factor.
We've actually done a very in-depth analysis relating to the high pressure in the Pacific. Recently, the change in the Indian Ocean sea temperature has had a great impact, and that is caused by the La Niña phenomenon, which means the effect of global climate change and global warming would be ranked third.
According to global greenhouse gas emissions data from the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency,The key greenhouse gases emitted by human activities are 76% of carbon dioxide from fossil fuel use, including from power plants and fuel combustion. The evidence suggests that if we reduce the dependency of fossil fuel for power generation, cars and motorbikes, we could save more time and delay the effects of extreme weather. The good news is that we have more electric vehicle makers around the world today, including the support by many governments to use EVs. However, the bad news is that demand oversupply of coal, oil, and gas is forcing major economies to depend on coal power use more than before. Is there anything that can be done to change this?
The goal of our joint efforts now is that the enterprise itself must also find ways to use renewable energy to generate electricity. Therefore, Thai Power has already set some relevant regulations. Large electricity users must provide 10% of renewable energy power. For example, during construction of a factory, solar panels can be installed on the rooftop to generate solar energy, or companies can invest in solar or wind power generation facilities nearby. Systems as such would meet the requirements.
According to media reports, on October 30, 2021, Thai Power has completed the commercial operation of the submarine power cable between Penghu and Taiwan. This means solar as well as wind turbine generated power will be shared between the islands, allowing Penghu to reduce its oil power electricity use. Besides using green energy, land transportation vehicle can also reduce the emission of carbon dioxide. Scientists have developed carbon capturing technology to decrease the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and Thai Power is one of those advanced technology developers.
We have a Taiwan Power Research Institute and are currently doing a simulation test site at the Taichung Power Plant and in the Changhua Coastal Industrial Area. It has been successfully operated. If the operation of this technology meets our expectations, we will be able to capture carbon emissions through installing certain equipment at the exit points of the existing gas or coal-fired power plants.
Carbon capture and storage is a way to decrease the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. This isn't a new solution. We've had a traditional and more organic method of doing so, called photosynthesis, which is the process in which green plants and other organisms use sunlight to synthesize nutrients from carbon dioxide and water. This is why the Amazon rainforest is such a crucial component, because it helps regulate the amount of carbon dioxide released globally. Taiwan's queen of reforestation, Chen Liyi, invented a pot that can reserve water for a longer period, allowing for plants to survive dry environments, such as in deserts or in times of drought.
在非常干旱, 然后雨水极少地区放,
in areas that are very dry with very little rain, it is rather better to plant trees in the winter during the dry season, but the condition is that one must use a water treasure pot. And to keep it during the winter season, adding water to the water treasure basin when it dries so that the sapling has a continuous water source to protect it. By spring, its roots would have developed intact, and when the rainy season comes, it will grow. When it grows to be strong enough, even when the summer sun and drought come, its resistance will be much better.
Former US President Barack Obama said, "The issue of climate change is not one that any single nation can solve by itself. It by definition requires cooperation among every country." In the same way, every single one of us has a role to play in this battle for change. It's hard to say for now if we are too late in our efforts. Regardless, we should do everything in our capacity to create a better and brighter tomorrow for generations to come.
接下来我们请Ruby介绍今天 Knowledge的学习重点吧。 Seeing all this extreme weather events caused by pollution, it really worries me.
Same. Why don't we talk about ways to go green today?
Oh, that's a good idea. 我习惯用自己的杯子还有餐具 to reduce the plastic waste.
And I take public transportation 来减少碳足迹。
碳足迹呢是...
A carbon footprint, 也就是一个人在日常活动中引起的温室气体排放。
I see. Usage of electricity, gasoline, transportation 都会产生碳排量。
Don't forget the food you eat. 你知道什么食物的碳排量最高吗?
I'm guessing meat?
Yes, cheese and eggs are also one of the highest.
Huh, so what can we eat to reduce the carbon footprint then?
Well, vegetables, beans, and nuts, they have much lower carbon footprints.
Oh, that's perfect. I love vegetables. Well, I'm Wade.
I'm Ruby.
I hope this episode of Knowledge was insightful and you learned some more English. Join us on the Fun Day website to watch more.
See you next time.